this experiment once with the Bible and the Quran. I was in a particularly feminist mood, and I started changing the pronouns in the Bible from he to she, and I was busting through it, boom, 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 crossing out. Sitting there with a book in my hands and a voice saying, "Charles, Chelsea, you're not doing what you said you were. You set out to do." And I realized that reading the Quran like put me into a state of like almost hypnosis. And I found that several times with the way that the language looks. I don't understand how I can feel so split about it, because there's parts of the religion itself that are very, like, make a lot of sense to me. Like, it's all very, like, logical prayer. Like, at certain times of the day, certain seasons, it, like, coincides with the season. Muslim men with their mothers, and they are just doting over her. They love her, like just totally love their mothers. No misogyny at all, like just doting over her. But I think in, you know, any situation you're gonna find, any religion you're gonna find people that respect their mothers and then people who don't. With my prayer practice, with my inquiry into praying, is I don't want to be like making deals, you know? Like, I'm already in debt. Like, I don't need to go further in debt with the gods. Like, whatever god I'm praying to, you know, whatever. You know, there's, I really do want to reiterate, though, that there are a few archangels that I have personally worked with that help me almost immediately, and it's like you can feel it physically. Like, I'll get visions, like just my mental state. It's actually sometimes so immediate that I actually reject it. Like, it happens right in front of my eyes, and I'm almost going, "That's it." Like it's that easy, it's that simple, and I reject. That profound that it can't be that instant. And I'm pretty sure that both if you repeat, it gives it more power. And that's something that I was thinking about with prayer. I've asked myself several times, like, you know, with like drugs and stuff, and like certain even relationships, types of relationships, or fixes, immediate fixes, you get immune to it. Immune to God. Like it just keeps expanding, like your knowledge and awareness of yourself and God and that interaction, the world, the universe. You can't get immune. It makes you actually stronger and more grounded and expand. Whereas like certain things like you just eventually get immune to and need something else or need like need something, whereas like with a prayer, like with it can hit pretty instantly. It's like magnificent, because it's very powerful. It's a very powerful thing, and it does rely on you going within and agreeing to align to that power. You have to agree to it on some level, you know, that's what you want to align to. I reckon, and you're gonna have to reckon with yourself about that agreement, because that's a good agreement to make, to want to be well and do right and align to the greatest love. Is a good thing to want. But yeah, so this, I just want to say, like, in terms of like religious affiliation, I have studied primarily Hinduism, Buddhism, Christianity, Islam, and you know, like a little bit of like the pagan, Wiccan, goddess kind of energy stuff, and spirituality. And I love the study of the way that different peacekeepers arrive. As soon as it starts getting political or judgmental or hateful, I have to tend to step out of the conversation, because I'm not interested in being right. In the sense that I know I can't be in this conversation because I don't know anything to be right about. So, prescribe somebody a mantra than a pill. So maybe that's what I should do. I'm not a doctor though, so no prescriptions from this one. Learning with prayer that
Mm-hmm.